In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
A very warm welcome to this Mass on the third Sunday after Trinity, our family Mass when some of our young people will be taking a bigger part in the service. And a special warm welcome to any visitors we have with us today. Dear friends, as we prepare to celebrate, let us call to mind our sins. In a dark and disfigured world, we have not held out the light of life. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
In a hungry and despairing world, we have failed to share our bread. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
In a cold and loveless world, we have kept the love of God to ourselves. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy upon us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Almighty God, you have broken the tyranny of sin and have sent the Spirit of your Son into our hearts, whereby we call you Father. Give us grace to dedicate our freedom to your service, that we and all creation may be brought to the glorious liberty of the children of God, through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
So we sit for our readings.
A reading from the book of Job. From the heart of the tempest, the Lord gave Job his answer. He said, "Who pent up the sea behind closed doors when it leapt tumultuous out of the womb, when I wrapped it in a robe of mist and made black clouds its swaddling bands. When I marked the bounds, it was not to cross, and made it fast with a bolted gate. Come thus far, I said, and no further. Here your proud waves shall break. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The sponsor's psalm is Alleluia.
Alleluia.
Some sailed to the sea in ships to trade on the mighty waters. These men have seen the Lord's deeds, the wonders he does in the deep.
Alleluia.
For he spoke, he summoned the gale, tossing the waves of the sea up to heaven and back into the deep. Their souls melted away in their distress.
Alleluia.
Then they cried to the Lord in their need, and he rescued them from their distress. He stilled the storm to a whisper. All the waves of the sea were hushed.
Alleluia.
They rejoiced because of the calm, and he led them to the heaven they desired. Let them thank the Lord for this love, for the wonders he does for men.
Alleluia.
A reading from the second letter of Paul to the Corinthians. The love of Christ overwhelms us when we reflect that if one man has died for all, then all men should be dead. And the reason he died for all was so that living men should live no longer for themselves, but for him who died and was raised to life for them. From now onwards, therefore, we do not judge anyone by the standards of their flesh. Even if we did once know Christ in the flesh, that is not how we know him now. And for anyone who is in Christ, there is a new creation. The old creation has gone, and now the new one is here. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Save Christ in power.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Hear the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Mark.
Glory to you, O Lord.
With the coming of evening, Jesus said to his disciples, "Let us cross over to the other side." And leaving the crowd behind, they took him, just as he was, in the boat. And there were other boats with him. Then it began to blow a gale, and the waves were breaking into the boat, so that it was almost swamped. But he was in the stern, his head on the cushion, asleep. They woke him and said to him, "Master, do you not care? We are going down." And he woke up and rebuked the wind and said to the sea, "Quiet now, be calm." And the wind dropped and all was calm again. Then he said to them, "Why are you so frightened? How is it that you have no faith?" They were filled with the awe and said to one another, "Who can this be? Even the wind and the sea obey him." This is the word, this is the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you.
Please take a seat. May I speak to the glory of God, who is Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. When there's something strange in the neighbourhood, who are you going to call?
Ghostbusters.
You all knew that, didn't you? Good. There's something strange going on, we call the Ghostbusters. Sorted. What about if the heating isn't working? Anyone? What do we do if the heating's not working? Church waters. Okay, what about the heating at home then? Gas board. Or plumber, or oil company, or whoever. What about if the electric isn't working at home? Electric company. I remember a couple of years ago, I arrived here in the morning, setting up for a wedding, and discovered the organ wasn't working. We had to call the electric board out, and discovered there was an extra fuse board, the other side of that pillar that none of us knew about before. So that was a waste of a call out, but well, how did we know? We knew the one behind the organ, we knew the one at the back. How are we to know there's a third fuse board in this place? What about if you're a young person and can't do your homework? You don't understand some of your homework, who do you call? The teacher. Excellent. We use Class Dojo to call the teacher and say we don't understand. It seems obvious. Call the experts if we can't do something. We call those who have been doing this particular thing for ages. Someone who knows all the answers. On the other hand, with it being Father's Day, we might just call Dad and say, "Dad, help. How do I do it?" Or ask your mum. This brings us to the gospel reading. In the boat are Jesus' disciples and Jesus. The disciples, some of them, what did some of them do for a job? Anyone remember what Peter did? I heard something over here. Peter, a fisherman, yes. Right, so there's a fisherman, at least one fisherman amongst Jesus' disciples. And there's Jesus, the son of a carpenter. So, fisherman, carpenter, boat, storm. Who knows most about being on a boat among those who were there? The carpenter or the fisherman? You'd think so, wouldn't you? Who will have been in more storms on a boat, do you think? Probably the fisherman. So who's more likely to know what to do if you get caught in a storm on a boat? You'd think it'd be the fishermen, wouldn't you? So what do they do? Who do they call? They call Jesus. The fishermen caught in a storm on a boat decide to call a carpenter and say, "Help, we're going to drown, we've got a storm." How on earth would he know more than them what to do? It's crazy if you think about it. But then, it was actually Jesus who had the answer, the solution, not them. Or rather, it was God who could sort it, rather than them relying on their experiences and skills. So often, in church and in other parts of our lives, we can tend to think only the most experienced, or the oldest, or those who have been here forever have all the answers, or only those who have been around forever are capable of doing things. That those who are newer, well, they wouldn't understand, they wouldn't have the experience, they wouldn't know what to do. We'd better keep doing it ourselves. But throughout Scripture, we see the complete opposite. If we'd been following the other pattern of Old Testament readings today, we would have had the account of David and Goliath. Goliath being a giant, David being a normal person, a young boy. Anyone remember who won, that young David and Goliath? Anyone heard that story? Excellent. What happens? David wins. You've got this giant, you've got this young kid, and the young kid wins. Then we think of Mary, young, unmarried, and being chosen by God to give birth to God made man, Jesus. Unexpected people being used by God, not just those who have been there, done that, got the t-shirt. The rule of Saint Benedict reminds us that God might well be speaking through the youngest, most inexperienced person. It might be the person you wouldn't think of, who is actually speaking the word of God, speaking God's will, God's plans into a situation. And of course, at the moment, it's Euro 2020. The football, even though it's 2021. Anyone watching any of the matches? One or two people? I finally watched a match the other day. I hadn't got round to it before. Back in 95, the football pundit, former Liverpool player, Alan Hansen, on Match of the Day, declared, "You can't win anything with kids. You've got a team full of kids, they've got no chance, they can't win the league." What happens? The Man United team, made up of all these youngsters, wins the league. The youngsters are doing things no one had expected it. And in fact, during this pandemic, I've heard time and time again about young people, or younger people maybe in some cases, being able to do things that older people, not old people, older people, couldn't do. Especially when it comes to FaceTime, Zoom, whatever other, WhatsApp, live streaming. It's how many of you, I wonder, have called someone younger than yourselves to help you set things up or help you fix it? A lot of people. You know, these young people, you might think, well, they don't know anything. They haven't lived through this, that, or the other. But actually, they have something to offer that we sometimes don't. And the pandemic, I think, with the technology, has reminded us of that. Because God can and does call people of all ages, all skills, all backgrounds, all experiences to do his work in the world. Not just calling the older people, but calling the younger people, and those in between come to that. Because each person has something to offer. And sometimes it is the most unexpected person who is the most useful, or who is called by God for some amazing ministry. Not just choosing the oldest, most experienced person all the time. In the Old Testament, God spoke these words through the prophet Joel. I will pour out my spirit on all flesh. Your sons and your daughters shall prophesy. Your old men shall dream dreams. And your young men shall see visions. God's calling to ministry, calling to do amazing things on old people and young people, and surely those in between too. We are not called to always go for the safe option, just doing what we've always done with the most experienced people who have done it a million times before. Because different people may well have different ideas, different gifts, and bring new and exciting possibilities that God wants to bring to fruition. We should be open to how God is calling each one of us to follow his call in our lives in this age. But that does not mean we can do it all ourselves. We can't. This is illustrated in the gospel reading. Because in the end, things are done by God's strength. It is in God's strength that we live and move and have our being, not just down to our own skills and abilities and experiences. And so I wonder, how is God calling each and every one of us to live our lives serving him in this age of 2021 and moving into the future? How is God calling each one of you? And it's exciting to think that we may in time find out how God has called us to serve him wherever we are. In the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. And so shall we stand as we declare our faith in God, who is Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. We believe in God the Father, from whom every family in heaven and on earth is named. We believe in God the Son, who lives in our hearts through faith and fills us with his love. We believe in God the Holy Spirit, who strengthens us with power from on high. We believe in one God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. Let us pray.
Dear Lord, thank you for all the dads. I hope they have a nice day.
Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
Dear Lord, we thank you for our fathers who love us greatly. We pray for those who cannot be with their fathers due to coronavirus. Lord, in your mercy.
Amen.
Dear Lord, we pray for all the children in Year 6 going to high school in September. Lord, in your mercy.
Dear God, this week my friends and I had our transition day to Year 7. We pray that as we move up, we will get to know the school and teachers. As the lessons get harder, please guide us for our education. Help us to feel excited about the change and the new experiences to come. Lord, in your mercy.
Yeah.
Precious Lord, we pray for all in hospital. We pray for the doctors and nurses who tend them. May you offer them tenderness in their hours of need. We pray for all that have asked for our prayers.
Janet LePage, Beryl Davey, Jonathan Charmley, Rex Champion, Father David Coleman, Pat Smith, Tony Hamill, Hilary Brown, Josh Barbey, and Julia Bentley.
Lord, in your mercy.
Dearest Lord, we pray for all families who have recently lost loved ones. We pray for all of the dads in heaven on this Father's Day. We also remember all whose anniversary of passing falls at this time, including
Elizabeth Jordan, Reginald Phillips, Elizabeth Kinney, Kyle O'Reilly, Anne Eldridge, Cyril Bugle, Beryl McLean, Marlene Baker, Nancy Hubert, Winifred Simon, Patricia Ozan, Michael Breo, Stan Martin, Margaret Membry, and Alfred Howard.
Merciful Father,
accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour Jesus Christ. Amen.
And so we stand for the peace. God is love, and those who live in love live in God, and God lives in them. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
With this bread that we bring,
we shall remember Jesus.
With this wine that we bring,
we shall remember Jesus.
Bread for his body, wine for his blood, gifts from God to his table we bring,
we shall remember Jesus.
The Lord is here.
His Spirit is with us.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give thanks and praise.
Lord of all life, you created the universe where all living things reflect your glory. You give us this great and beautiful earth to discover and to cherish. You give us happy times and things to celebrate. In these we taste your kingdom, a feast for all your children. You made us all, each wonderfully different, to join with the angels and sing your praise. We thank you, loving Father, because when we turned away, you sent Jesus, your Son. He gave his life for us on the cross and shows us the way to live. Send your Holy Spirit. that these gifts of bread and wine may be for us Christ's body and his blood. On the night before he died, when darkness had fallen, Jesus took bread. He gave thanks, broke it, and shared it with his disciples, saying, "This is my body, given for you. Do this to remember me." After they had eaten, he took the cup of wine, gave thanks, and shared it with his disciples, saying, "This is my blood, poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins." So, Father, with this bread and this cup, we celebrate his love, his death, his risen life. As you feed us with these gifts, send your Holy Spirit and change us more and more to be like Jesus, our Saviour. Help us, Father, to love one another as we look forward to that day when suffering is ended and all creation is gathered in your loving arms. And now, with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Saint Michael, and all the saints, we give you glory through Jesus Christ in the strength of the Spirit, today and forever. Amen. Let us pray with confidence as our Saviour has taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. We break this bread to share in the body of Christ. Though we are many, we are one body, because we all share in one bread. This is the table, not of the church, but of the Lord. It is to be made ready for those who love him a little and want to love him more. So come, you who have much faith and you who have little, you who have been here often and you who have not been for a long time, you who have tried to follow and you who have failed. Come, not because it is I who invite you, it is our Lord. It is his will that those who seek him should meet with him here. Come.
Thank you.
Let us pray. We thank you, Lord, that you have fed us in this sacrament, united us with Christ, and given us a foretaste of the heavenly banquet prepared for all peoples. Amen. Please take a seat for the notices.
Yes, I'm back. Thank you, Nikki, for doing the notices and the 3 Sundays I was away. I'm COVID-free, you'll be pleased to know, so you can actually come up and say hello to me, hopefully. Warm welcome to all any visitors here this morning. Please join us for refreshments as being served after the service. Forthcoming services are on the news sheet. Just to point out, on the 26th, the bells will be chimed rather than rung. This is in celebration of the bicentenary of the Reverend Edicombe's invention of a chiming apparatus, one of which we have up there in the tower. Hopefully, if Stuart gets up the ladder, he'll be able to live stream it on Saturday. Where's Stuart?
Here.
Yeah. Oh, you're there, sorry. Where would you be live streaming?
On Facebook.
It'd be live streamed on Facebook, on the Vale Church's Facebook page. Right, C-Weekend, that's coming up fairly quickly. You'll notice there's thank you for all those who signed up to steward. We do need some more. I see there's one slot where I've said I'll sign up, but I'm there by myself, so I need some help, please. So if you're able to come along, either the Friday, the Saturday or the Sunday, please do so and please sign up so we know how many are coming. Also, those who agreed to make cakes or brought Tom Polo prizes. We can never have too many cakes, so the more the merrier. If you're unable to come along and help out with any of those, perhaps a small donation of milk, napkins, etc., or even funds to purchase them. A note from Pauline, next Sunday is the last Sunday before the Sea Festival, so if you've been knitting fishes, please bring them along to the service. Also, if you've offered to lend artefacts or pictures, can these also be brought along, and we will store them safely in the choir vestry till we set up the displays on the following Thursday. If anything needs collecting, please see Pauline today if possible. Thank you. And there are posters at the back of the church. If you can take one and put it somewhere, not just restricted to the Vale Parish, all over the island. I have sent one through to the Guernsey churches, so they've been sent around all the churches on the island. There's also a concert on the Saturday evening, and I can't remember who they are, but there is a poster by the gate at the bottom of the church. I'll try and remember for next week. Birthdays. Have we got any birthdays, Val?
Oh, sorry, Mike. Can I say
that? Oh, sorry.
As well as a concert on Saturday night by a choir.
Oh, yes, of course.
The music group will also be singing from 3 to about 3:45 on Saturday afternoon.
And also on the Sunday afternoon, the ad hoc recorders will be playing their recorders, hurdy-gurdies, and anything else. They're a group that use the bit in Les Norm room for practice. So I asked them if they'd like to do something, and they spoke to Pauline. So they'll be playing most of Sunday afternoon. And hopefully, in conclusion of that, the festival, the bell ringers will be ringing at 4 o'clock-ish, a quarter period in celebration of the success, we hope, of that of this festival. Birthdays, right, where's Val? Val, you've got a birthday coming up, haven't you? No, it's today, isn't it? Yes. Are there any other birthdays to celebrate with Val? No. Val, come on, dear, up you come. I know you're getting old. I'm sure you can manage it. No, you're only as old as you feel, Val. Val's a good number change today. Coming up into 70, well done.
Thank you very much.
It's some refreshments. I know, we saw cake and booze. Much better than coffee.
Thank you.
Indeed.
Happy birthday.
as I'm here, I thought I might stay here. Also with the Sea Sunday, the service, the 10:30 service on the morning, will be a songs of praise kind of service rather than a parish mass. So if you'd like to receive communion on that day, you've got to get up a bit early, I'm afraid, for the 8 o'clock. But we look forward to that service, and we've got Major Jamie Hill coming from just over the, no, not outside the parish, just on the edge of the parish for them from the Salvation Army. So we look forward to him opening up God's word on the seas, but not on the same reading in the gospel as we've had today. Also, it's great, Jem, it's great having you with us today, and you're in the middle of a charity campaign, aren't you? Excellent. So yeah, so the 50 frocks, 50 days. I'm sure most women can't manage 50 different frocks, can they? Or am I just sort of imagining things? I don't know. Either or just don't take notes of what's in the wardrobe. But thank you for what you're doing for the Pink Ladies, Gem. And if anyone would like to sponsor Gem as well, well, please speak to her. And I'm sure she'll be happy to raise more than £400. I can't think of anything else to say, so shall we stand as we pray for God's blessing? The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Bow your heads and pray for God's blessing. The God of hope, fill you with all joy and peace in believing. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you always. Amen.